Hi there! Thank you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. This video is part of the series of videos I'm posting to try to help people out when it comes to aptitude tests. Now, today we're going to talk about another study hack video. I've made a series of these videos na to try to help people study better, learn better, and basically perform better when it comes to tests. Now, whether you're taking the civil service exam like most of my students, or another exam entirely, or you're just taking a regular exam because you're still in school, I hope that this video will be helpful for you. Now, one thing that I always get all the time sa mga students ko, lalo na dahil papalapit ng exam, is this, okay? Ang question nila lagi is, paano po ako magre-relax? Bakit? Kasi ang unang kalaban ng mga tao when they take the test is kaba. Nervous. Okay? Anxiety. Worry. And a lot of times, marami na ang naka-experience na when they worry, they have a hard time answering questions, even the easy ones na alam nila. Now, the reason for that in educational psychology is that we have trouble retrieving memories pag nasa stress tayo or under duress tayo. That is the reason why sa mga shows like Wawa Win or yung mga ganong klaseng quiz shows, game shows na mabilisan yung pagtanong sa mga audience members, there are a lot of audience members who get the answers wrong. For example, I've seen someone ask na ano ang Tagalog ng talong, and they would respond eggplant, right? But the truth is, the answer ng Tagalog ng talong is still talong. Bakit? Kasi nga nagkakamali dahil sa nervyos, dahil under time pressure, dahil gustong-gustong manalo. Okay? So ano ibig sabihin na? There are ways for us to control these emotions, to make it work for us better. And those are the things that I want to talk to you about. Okay? So number one, that we're going to talk about is perspective. Ano yung perspective? Pananaw. Okay? Anong ibig sabihin nun? Kasi ganito yun. A lot of the students that I have also have a hard time relaxing during the exam kasi marami silang mga worries about yung consequences ng exam that they're going to take. Now, what I want you to understand is that perspective beats pressures. Ibig sabihin kasi, ang pananaw natin will beat yung unrealistic or yung sobrang bigat na pressure na binibigay sa atin ng exam. Now, some of my students would tell me, kailangan ko po kasi coach ipasa exam kasi kung hindi tatanggalin ako sa trabaho. Kailangan ko ipasa exam kasi kung hindi, hindi ako mapapromote. Kailangan ko ipasa exam for my family, for my children. And that is also true. All of those reasons are valid and those are really valuable to all of you guys. And I understand that. However, if you don't let go of those reasons before you take the exam, those will turn mula sa motivation, kasi dati motivation sila, those will turn into pressure. And I've had students na magsasabi sa akin na totoo ito, and maybe you're one of those people, so hit like if you agree, ha? Na pagdating sa exam, dahil nga masyado silang burdened by that need to pass, hindi na sila makapag-perform better. Naiiyak sila, kinakabahan sila. Pag nagkamali sila sa isang tanong, feeling nila babagsak na sila. Dahil nga dun sa unrealistic na pressure na binigay natin sa sarili natin. So, yung perspective nyo will battle that pressure. Ano yung perspective? It's this. The truth of the matter is, okay, whoever you are at nasaan ka mang panahon sa buhay mo, ano mang exam yung itatake ninyo, this won't be the last opportunity na darating sa buhay ninyo. What do I mean by that? It's true. Maybe this is the time for you na kailangan mong talagang pumasa ng exam. However, okay, there are always other opportunities na darating in life, okay? If you're taking a college entrance exam and napapressure kayo kasi gusto nyo makapasok ng University of the Philippines, okay? I know, I understand, isang take lang ang UPCAT. And if you don't pass, okay, probably you won't start in that school. However, that is not the last opportunity for you. Bakit? Kasi I've had mga batchmates ko from Kisay na they did not start out in UP, pero nag-transfer sila from UST, from FEU, or all of those colleges, and eventually, they graduated in UP. Okay, unlike me, I got in, but I did not finish there. So ano ibig sabihin nun? That exam is just one opportunity. There are other opportunities like it na darating pa. Now, if you're taking the civil service exam, I know that you really want to pass, and I also want you to pass, but think of it this way. Next year, there will be another exam. Ang goal natin is improvement. Ibig sabihin, for you to do great in this exam right now. But if, worst case scenario, you don't do well, that's okay. There's going to be another exam next year. You can always keep trying. And in life, okay, hindi naman nangyayari na isang exam ang magdedetermine ng life or death ninyo. You have to change your perspective. Kasi one thing that helped me and I believe my sisters, kasi lahat naman kami hindi masyadong nininervous pagdating sa exams, is that now we know that God is in control and we know that our life is going to go on even after the test, nalilet go namin yung nervous namin pagdating sa exam. Kasi if it is within God's will for you to pass, no matter how bad you think you're going to do, God will fill in kung ano yung kakulangan ninyo. Okay? So again, perspective combats pressure. So mag-iba tayo ng perspective pagdating sa exam. Don't think of it as the one time, big time na magdedetermine ang future ninyo. Instead, think of it as just an opportunity. Now, another relaxation tip is this, pray. Okay? So pray. Bakit kayo magpe-pray? Now, it's also been proven by psychology, regardless of your religion, regardless of your faith. In my case, okay, since I'm an evangelical Christian, I pray before I take the test. I pray the night before. I pray a lot, okay? I try to do my best to parang interact with God as much as possible and surrender a lot of my worries to Him. And that can actually calm your brain down. Again, this has been proven by MRI, CT scans, mga ganong klaseng mga exams, CAT scans. So make sure that you pray, okay, before taking the test. Now, if you're not that religious, even meditation, even doing that will help you calm down before taking the exam. But in my case, and yun din ang suggestion ko for you guys, go and pray. Kasi this will help you na tanggalin yung some of the weight then of what is going to happen from your shoulders. Pasan nyo na, i-surrender nyo na kay God. And there is a great verse na lagi yung ginagamit when I teach, which is in James 1:5. Okay, now if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask from God, and God will give generously to all without finding fault. Ibig sabihin, kung kukulangan ka sa pag-aaral or sa kakayanan mo, go and ask God. And that is actually the verse na paborito rin ng lola ko. And that verse has brought me through a lot of the exams that I already took. So you can remind yourself of that. And a lot of the other verses din, some of those you can find sa likod ng mga reviewers that I send out if you have one of those. Okay? Now, another piece of advice would be this. Breathe. Ano ibig sabihin ng breathe? Kasi, a lot of the people na nagtitake ng exam, pagdating sa actual exam, nagpapalpitate na sila, hinihingal na sila. And I've experienced that. In fact, yung katabi ko nung nag-upcat ako was, alam niyo yun, parang nag-breathe siya talaga, nang hyperventilate na siya nung nag-exam kami. Ganyan siya huminga. Alam niyo yung parang mga nganak. Ganun siya. But the thing is, lalaki siya. And hinihingal siya throughout the entire exam. Now, I know na the reason why nangyayari yun is because sobrang kaba niya sa exam. So, paano ba ang tamang pag-breathe para to calm yourself down? Now, I know this kasi I get nervous a lot. In fact, even before shooting this video, masyado akong kinakabahan kasi may mga dumadaan dito sa my room namin. Kasi I'm shooting this sa Capiz, may mga naglalakad. So, kinakabahan ako kasi baka marinig nila ako dahil mahihain nga akong tao. Okay? So, what do? You breathe in, and then you breathe out slowly. Okay? And you can actually feel na parang kumakalma ka. Again, you breathe in, and then breathe out slowly. Okay? Now, hindi katulad ng ginagawa nung katabi ko nga nung exam kasi ganun siya eh. Okay? And doing that will actually make your heart race. Bibilis lalo yung tibok ng puso ninyo, lalo kayong kakabahan. So, kailangan mo deep breath, and then breathe out slowly. Exhale slowly. And if you do that, I hope that you're trying it with me, you will actually feel lighter. You will actually feel less stressed. And you can actually do that before taking the test or even during the exam. If you feel at any point during the exam na parang nila sumusobra na yung kaba ko, sobra na yung pagpapalpitate ko, put your pen down, take just a few seconds, hinga ka muna. Okay, bakit? Kasi the more na kinakabahan ka na kayo, nagbi-build up yan, and lalong lalala yan. So, even before kayong bumigay yung katawan ninyo sa nervyos, stop yourself and then breathe muna to try to relax. Alright? So, again, proper breathing. Now, another trick is body language. Now, bakit? Kasi ganito yun. In psychology, you have yung triangle ng affect, behavior, and cognition. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Yung affect or yung feeling, emotion, yung behavior, yung ginagawa ng katawan, at yung cognition or yung nangyayari sa utak, they affect each other. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Kung ano yung nararamdaman ninyo is influenced by what you're doing physically, and that also affects what you're doing mentally. Now, pagdating sa exam, kailangan yung mental attitude natin in tip-top shape. Ibig sabihin, best mental capacity. And that will only happen if your body is not tense and if your feeling is not that tense din. And the best way for you to trick your body into thinking na okay lang lahat is through movement. Okay? Now, if you notice, kunyari, kinakabahan kayo. Tapos, dahil kinakabahan kayo, you're doing this. Okay? Or yung nagka-crack kayo ng knuckles mo ganyan. O kaya nag-shake kayo ganyan. Okay? Ganyan ka. Tapos nagpe-pace ka. Hindi pa lalo kang kinakabahan. Okay? If you've ever experienced na yung kinakabahan kayo, isang lalakad kayo to and fro. Okay? Mapapansin mo, habang ginagawa mo yun, it doesn't relieve the stress. In fact, habang naglalakad ka, mas tumitindi yung stress, mas mabilis ka maglakad, mas kinakabahan ka. So, anong gagawin natin? Lolokohin natin yung sarili natin na kunyari hindi ka kinakabahan. And how do you do that? Okay? You lean back, okay? Sa pagdating sa exam, huwag kayong ganyan. Yun, di ba yung parang squirrel ka or mouse ka na parang maliit ka. Ang gagawin ninyo is relax, okay? Sandal ka, lay back, okay, chill lang, i-ano niyo yung shoulders ninyo, relax ka lang. And when you do that, you will trick your body, you will trick your mind into thinking na, okay, relaxed pala tayo ngayon, hindi pala tayo nagpapanik. Kasi the more na ganyan ka, the more na ganun ka, lalo kang kakabahan. And when kabado ka, it will affect your mental state. Okay, so body language ang pinag-uusapan. Now, another component ng trying to relax is your diet. Okay? Now, we all know na when you take in too much caffeine, ibig sabihin, nagkape kayo tatlong cups, ganun, bago mag-exam, probably niya magpapalpitate talaga kayo. If you take in too much sugar, that can also affect your mental capacity. So, try to limit your intake, okay, ng kape at saka ng sugars before taking the test. Kasi that can also affect yung inyong physical na reaction sa exam. Okay? So those are some of the things that you can try out pagdating sa relaxation. I suggest that habang may time pa kayo before the exam, you do it before you take your practice tests or you take your before you have your review para doon pa lang nakikita na ninyo kung anong mga techniques ang nag-work for you. Okay? Now, just a little bit of sharing din on my side, on my part. I'm going to tell you the prayer that I usually do when I take the test, okay? So, every time I take the test, I have this line, okay, na I always add in my prayer. Syempre, you pray naman the way that you pray, you talk to God. But there's this line that I always add at the end, okay? When I take the test or when I speak in front of large crowds or when I teach you guys, I always say this, okay? I say, let your will be done and may your name be glorified. So, I tell God, let your will be done. Ibig sabihin yung kalooban ninyo ang mangyari. Ibig sabihin nun, I surrender this to you. Now, if you're a Christian, you're familiar with that kasi nasa Lord's Prayer din yan, right? Nasa prayer ni Jesus. Let your will be done, okay? So, let your will be done and may your name be glorified. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Now, whatever happens dun sa exam, whether you pass, you fail, or in my case, top the test, si Lord ang itataas ninyo dun. Si Lord ang mag-glorify. Yung pangalan niya ang matatanyag because of what happened. And when you do that, in my experience, God has always been faithful naman to me. Okay? Now, pagdating sa exam kasi wala na tayong magagawa. Sa araw ng exam, you can't add sa knowledge ninyo pa. Wala na kayong may dadagdag. So, just do your best. Okay? Let God do the rest. Try your best. Okay? Hanggang dun lang ang magagawa natin. And then you just wait prayerfully for the results. Okay? So I hope you learned something. I hope you try these out. I hope some of them work for you. If they did, please let me know. And again, if you have any questions or gusto nyo mag-reach out to me directly through my Facebook page, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlaika for all of the attitude test tips, tricks, and techniques. Okay, so thank you guys for watching and I hope you subscribe to this channel. Hit the bell icon if you're watching this on YouTube para sa, as soon as the new video posts, you'd know kung meron ng bago. Okay? So right now, I'm here at Capiz Mansions. It was a great stay and it was a great meeting Team Laika Capiz. The next time I'm going to teach, it's going to be in Metro Manila again for the August 6 exam. And there are more stuff coming out, so I hope that you subscribe to this channel para alam ninyo yun. Okay? So thank you guys. God bless. Aja, kaya niyan. I hope you do great sa exam ninyo. Bye for now.